I mean, really it was just about getting the reps, right? And obviously there's a reason why Pat is Pat. And, you know, he's had the success that he's had. You know, it's evident every single day. And like you said, it started, you know, right after the season when, you know, we were before OTA. So, you know, to be able to learn and to be able to start to compete with him and understand him and how he looks at the game and views the game and approaches it, you know, it's really just been a blessing for me. And I'm grateful to, you know, be in the position to learn from somebody like him and of his status and, you know, just trying to implement the positive aspects of his game into my own.
Nathan's kind of favored you as one of the lead kick returners. What have you learned about the new kickoff? How comfortable do you feel in that position?
Yeah, no, I feel extremely comfortable. It's very different. It tends to happen a bit quicker, which I believe tends to my game a little bit more. Just, you know, you got to change direction in a quicker amount of time and a shorter amount of space. So it's going to be fun to see how it evolves. It's something that's going to be constantly changing, I think, as the season goes on. And, you know, to be in the position that I'm in now, to be learning and, you know, just seeing the different ways that coach is thinking, I'm excited to see what it can evolve into.
Nikko, I know that you signed here as a UDFA. Can you talk about what led you to sign here? Did you have other teams, like, garnering your interest?
I did. You know, it was just a conversation that I had with my agent, and him and I both felt that this was the best spot for me to be at, and you know, by no means has it been easy, and it's still not easy, but you know, I'm just trying to punch every single day and put my best foot forward and be the best version of myself to make sure that I can find a role somewhere on this team.
Can you say how many teams you had at the point?
Oh man, I couldn't tell you right now, but it was a lot. You know how it is on draft day. So
why did you feel like this was the best place
to be? I felt like there was an opportunity at returner, and I mean, shoot, it's the Chiefs, man. You got an opportunity to play with the Super Bowl champions. It's hard to say no to that. And, you know, for me, I felt like if I'm able to compete here, you know, I can compete anywhere. And so I'm just trying to take everything in day by day and learn. And like I said, most of all, I'm just grateful to be here.
What's the mentality that you're taking to get through camp, especially with the C guys going down?
Yeah. Yeah, just staying resilient. And that's really been, you know, kind of the moral of my entire journey, is just staying resilient and continuing to punch. You know, I've always been an underdog at every single level of football that I've played at. So, you know, being in this position is nothing new to me. So just making sure that I'm still fighting and like I said, being the best version of myself every single day. Well, I think the obvious one is just familiarity with the offense. You know, I'm sure you guys have heard it numerous of times how extensive and intricate the details and little nuances of the offense are. So being able to continue learning that and then extending that even further, understanding how Pat likes the details and the nuances in the offense. And so I think being able to sit back for a year and kind of see how that's evolved is a big one for me that I'm trying to apply now. And then I think just things that I learned throughout the season was, you know, the ebbs and flows of the season. It's constantly changing. And, you know, again, it's resilience. You got to be able to stay resilient. And that's one of the big things that I learned.
Is there an example of whether it's with Pat or the offense where you can tell within yourself that this is better than what it was a year ago?
Yeah, I think just reads, like knowing, you know, if I'm going to sit in this zone or, you know, how I'm wrapping around the defenders and different zone looks and feeling space. A lot of the offense is feeling space and being able to find, you know, big open fields of grass to be able to run to and feel and sit in. And those have been the biggest things that I think makes the biggest difference. Like, you're not just running the straight lines on the playbook, right?
We'll go right down the line. Sam, Herbie, Matt, DJ.
Nikko, what was your Super Bowl experience watching?
Yeah, I was there on the sideline. Man, I mean, I think that's every kid's dream to be able to be at the Super Bowl and see that. But if I'm going to be completely honest, it was a bit of a mix of emotions for me. You know, I'm a competitor at heart. And so to not be able to be out there on the field and kind of just being on the sideline supporting, you know, obviously I'm grateful to be in that position. But you know, I want to play. So.
Has that stuck with you?
Absolutely.
Nikko, touching on your cultural aspect here, there are a lot of Polynesians in the National Football League, but when I think of Kanois, I can only probably think of Doug Baldwin, former Seahawks receiver. What does it mean to you, and how much pride do you take in being a Kanoi in the National Football League?
You see it right here, man. Yeah. I mean, it's everything to me. You know, my culture, my family, it's the biggest reason why I'm here right now. And, you know, when I go out there every single day, I'm not only representing myself and my last name, but like you said, a whole community of people. So, you know, to be able to be on this platform and to be able to represent them in a positive light, you know, I don't take that lightly at all.
You mentioned being a competitor, and you've made a lot of great plays so far in camp. I know one of the first emotions I saw was you know, one-on-ones, you had a really tough catch you make today, and I saw you were frustrated. And just how competitive are you, would you say, maybe compared to some of your teammates?
I wouldn't compare it to any of my teammates, because at the end of the day, none of us would be here if we weren't competitors. You know, but just understanding there's ebbs and flows to the game, and it's not always going to go my way. That's what makes the good moments so good and so exciting and so much fun. You know, you have to feel those lows, and you have to experience the drop balls and whatnot to be able to enjoy any success that you find in this game. And so, like I said, resilience, just continuing to punch and put my best foot forward every single day is what I'm striving to do.
Nikko, I know guys kind of on the roster bubble, they try not to think about it as you go out there and play, but to just know that you've been on the line, this is now your second year now, that you're kind of right on that active roster line where you can be a key contributor, just what's that feeling like? Can you describe just knowing that you're doing this every day, knowing that like the chance is right there for you?
Yeah, I think, you know, for me, regardless of, you know, where my status is at, it doesn't necessarily change my approach. And so my approach has to be consistent. If, you know, I'm a big neutral mindset type of guy, you know, not getting too high, not getting too low. And if you have those external factors that I don't necessarily have the entire control of, right? Like I got to approach the game the way I approach the game, and whatever decisions have to be made are those decisions. You know, I can't let that deter me from how I approach and how I approach my controllables. So I don't think too much into it.
Nikko, Coach Nagy has described you as an absolute true professional. What types of things do you think you're doing behind the scenes to lead to that impression?
Yeah, I mean, it's just the way you approach the meeting room, the way you approach your recovery, the way you approach your work, your intentionality with your work. You know, I think there's a big difference between working hard and working hard intentionally to be able to focus on a specific thing that you're improving on. And so, you know, like I said, just making sure that I'm trying to maximize each of those different columns every single day is, I believe, what it entails to be a pro. Again, it's something that I'm still learning, right? And so to be able to be around Pat, to be able to be around Hollywood, Travis, you know, a lot of those veteran guys that we have on the team, you know, I'm just kind of picking and trying to be a sponge around those guys, really.
Perfect. Thank you.
Thank you.